मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इट्स मी नितिन मैथ्यू हु विल बी टीचिंग इंग्लिश फॉर ग्रेड 5. आई एम हैप्पी टू हेल्प यू इन इम्पार्टिंग द नॉलेज. सो द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज कंपेयर एंड कॉन्ट्रास्ट इन द लेसन ए डे इन द लाइफ ऑफ ए वॉशरमैन. सो द एम ऑफ आवर लेसन इज टू कंपेयर एंड कॉन्ट्रास्ट द कैरेक्टर्स डेली रूटीन विथ देयर ओन. The key words we will be dealing today are compare, connection, contrast, first, second, and third. Now, dear students, you can see few pictures here. You can see a mother, you can see a father, you can see a milkman, and you can see a vegetable seller. So, can we say that the works that they do are same? No, right? The works that they are doing might be different, or it can be same at some times. So let's see in the life of a mother. She does all the work at home. She prepares, she cooks everything for children and family. And father, he does all the work in the office. And comparing a milkman and a vegetable man, we can see that a milkman sells milk and from morning, or he does in the evening. Or a vegetable seller, we can say that he sells vegetables every day. So there can be differences and there can be similarities in their life, right? Now today we are going to make connections between the story and our lives. As we saw in the previous picture, you can see some connections with their life. But today we are going to make connections between the story and our lives. Compare and contrast our daily routine with washermans. That is what we are going to do today. So we are going to compare and contrast our daily routine with washermans. Now, dear students, looking at the life of a washerman and looking at myself or looking at ourselves, let's say at first that the washerman cleaned the shack and fed the stray dog. He cleaned the shack and fed the stray dog. So comparing to that, we can say that I wake up and brush my teeth and have a bath. That's what I do, and the washerman does in a different way. But it can be like a similar way. So he prepared a small meal for himself, and I eat the breakfast prepared by my mother. So he got onto his bicycle and rode past the tall buildings. That's what he does. What I do, then I go to school by bus. So I use bus and he use cycle. Can still find that some similarity, that I am going to school and he is going for work. He greeted the watchman. Whom do I greet? Yes, I greet my friends. And he pulled out his notebook and went to collect clothes for washing. So what I do in that place? I learn new things at school. Yes. Coming to washerman's life, he cycled to Dhobigad and washed and dried his clothes. That's what he does. And later I eat my lunch and play during the recess. That's what I do. He folded his clothes, went home and smiled seeing his dog. What do I do? I go home, watch TV and do my homework. Even though works are different, the responsibilities are different, there are some similarities comparing to the life of a washerman, right? Now, we can also find some differences in the life of or the daily routine from the life of washerman and from myself. So washerman goes to collect clothes in the morning while we come to school. So that's what I do. I come to school and washerman, what he does? He collects clothes and washes. He reaches home and irons clothes in the late afternoon while we reach home and do homework or go to play. So there are also differences that we can find from the life of a washerman and from the life of each one of us, right? Yes. Now, by making connections, we remember something about our own lives that reminds us of what is happening in the story. So we remember something about our own lives, and that reminds us of what is happening in the story. As we read a story, it gives some connections from our life too. So by comparing and contrasting, we make a connection to our daily routine with that of the story we read, and it helps us to understand the story much easier. What helps us to understand a story much easier? It is that which we make our connection of the particular story and our daily routine. That makes us more clarity with regard to a story. Now coming to words that are showing compare and contrast. Words showing compare and contrast. Which are the words that show this comparison and contrast? That is like, unlike, both, and but. These are the words that show or that we use to compare and contrast something with the other. Okay, so these are the words. Remember, like, unlike, both, and but. To revise what we have learned today, let's see. We have learned about connections, that we learned about how to make connections with some other incident or some other story. And we also saw how to compare and contrast. To compare and contrast, we also used a few words. Which are the words? Yes, we used like, unlike, both, and but. These are the words we used. Now, dear students, I hope this learning experience was useful and informative. And I think that you have got a better understanding of the concept of compare and contrast. So have a nice day. Thank you.